Hi there, today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about some new horror fiction from HWA authors. And Typical Books has been voted one of the top 35 Canadian book podcasts by FeedSpot. So thank you very much, FeedSpot. They have a panel of people who call the internet for blogs and video shows like this one and podcasts. And I made it into the top 35. It was a very welcome surprise email on Friday from the founder of FeedSpot, so thank you very much. And thank you all for whoever has listened and tuned into this as a podcast or a show, because I really don't separate the two. It's all me, all the time. Speaking of all me, all the time, it's first 50 pages of my current work in progress. I've got a couple things on the go, of course, the Nightface 2 book and Pray Light Eve 3, but this particular story has been taking a bit because I find that this situation that we're all in has not been conducive to creativity for me, although at first I thought it would be. And, you know, we're going to celebrate quite a few of the authors who have taken that ball and ran with it, because there's a lot of really cool horror fiction coming out right now. So here are some authors who have not succumbed to any sort of stall and been creating great horror fiction with some new releases coming out soon. In my last video, I mentioned that there was a Tim Waggoner book, Your Turn to Suffer, that I neglected to mention in the comments. I had mentioned this. And so here we are, Tim Waggoner, Your Turn to Suffer from Flame Tree Press. It is out now. Lorelai is harassed by a sinister group calling themselves the Cabal. They accuse her of having committed unspeakable crimes in the past, and now she must pay. They take her life apart one piece at a time, and she must try to figure out what the Cabal thinks she's done and if she's to have any hope of salvaging her life. I really like the cover of this book. More cool covers. There'll be a couple in this clutch, as there always are, that really appeal to me. The Promise Keeper by Al Marie Wood. This comes from Cedar Grove Books and is out really soon. A young girl on the cusp of sexual maturity is what is now known as benign. West Africa is seduced by a beautiful stranger, a man the likes of which she's never seen before. Their encounter changes her forever. She becomes an Asman, a vampire, one of the undead. Intriguing. Another L. Marie Wood title called Telecommuting, and this is from Mocha Memoirs Press, which you may recall put out Slay, the vampire anthology. And this is out soon as well. Telecommuting is a modern psychological horror story set in what could be your town, your street, your home. The lyrical slow burn is subtle. The terror in this tale sneaks up on you before you know it. So it doesn't tell you much about it, but the title alone, Telecommuting, a very subdued cover on this book. But yeah, Telecommuting, I'm all about that. Matters Most Macabre by Tylor James. This is a Kindle release, and it is out soon. A collection of 13 spine-tingling tales from the maniacal mind of Tylor James. These stories will amuse, disturb, provoke thought, and just plain weird you out. We all like a little weird around here, don't we? With a very graphic cover, we have Stained Mirror, a Serial Killer Memoir. The title alone grabbed me here, by Gianni Franco, and this is out today. Rough and tumble Sergeant Frank Stark, working for the RPD in upstate New York, teeters on a tightrope of cop and killer. He seeks acceptance from his psychiatrist, co-workers, and himself, most of all, but the screaming voices fraying his sanity have other plans. Now, if you're a fan of Dexter, I think this is going to ratchet it up a notch. Next up is The Mother We Share by Jennifer Soucy from RhetAskew Publishing, and it is out now. Evie's stalked by a girl who isn't quite human, a creature that may be her twin. A changeling, like in the folklore her mother believed until her death. The twins loose on Beltane, hungry for the life she was denied. After a series of attacks, Evie must make a decision, fight the monster or guide her lost sister home before someone gets hurt. Or worse. 99 Nightmares by Joseph VanBuren. This is from Sykophunk Productions. This is the second release from this house. I'm going to have to look them up because I'd never heard of them before, and it is out already. Dark poetry inspired by a multitude of fears, real, imagined, and everything in between. Experimental verse using the themes and imagery of horror to offer social commentary and tell personal stories of struggles with mental health and addiction. Poetry is really the thing to do in horror right now, isn't it? I like this cover, The Devil's Mistress by David Barclay, and this is from Silver Shamrock. It's out already. Isabella appears to have the perfect life, a wealthy family, an ambitious fiancé, and servants to fulfill her every need. But after visiting the local apothecary for a simple love spell, she finds herself in shackles, accused of murder and witchcraft. Now, I'm curious about when this takes place. If this is Regency, I would really like to dig my teeth into this, for sure. And last but not least, Family Solstice by Kate Mariama, and I like this cover too, coming from Omnium Gatherum. It's out already. Shay Massey knows that whatever happens in the basement of her family home every December 21st makes it possible for the Masseys to spend the rest of the year enjoying their home and all it brings. Fighting that thing is her family duty, but something about this year is different. Mama's extra quiet this fall, and the house is breathing early. Mariama explores the dangers of tradition, inheritance, and the sins of the father in this horror novella. So a nice short read, it sounds. So yeah, that is that for upcoming horror. And I'm excited to check out a couple of these, specifically The Devil's Mistress. That sounds super fun. If you've read any of those books already, definitely let me know in the comments below, or if you have added them just now to your growing list of books to read. Thank you again for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.